G'day! This is Pythagoras. About 2,000 years ago, Pythagoras created a rule to calculate the lengths of the sides of right-angle triangles.
Aha!
Here is his rule. The longest side is called the hypotenuse. It's marked with the letter C. The other sides are A and B. Pythagoras' rule is C squared equals A squared plus B squared. Let's see the visual proof of why this works, and then we'll do many real-life examples. First, we draw a square on the side marked A. The rule for the area of a square is side multiplied by side, so that's A multiplied by A, or A squared. Now we draw a square on the side marked B. The area of this square is B multiplied by B, or B squared. Last, we draw a square on the longest side marked C. The area of this square is C multiplied by C, or C squared. Now look at this. The area of the large square equals the areas of the two smaller squares. So, C squared equals A squared plus B squared. We use this rule to calculate the lengths of all three sides of any right-angle triangle. Now let's see an example. This escalator is a right-angled triangle where the sides that make the right angle are 3 metres and 4 metres long. Pythagoras' rule to find the hypotenuse is C squared equals A squared plus B squared. A equals 3 and B equals 4. So, A squared equals 3 times 3, B squared equals 4 times 4, 3 times 3 is 9, 4 times 4 is 16, so when we add them, 9 plus 16 is 25, so C squared equals 25. But we want to find the length of C, not C squared, so there is one more step. We square root 25 to find C, so C equals 5. The length of the hypotenuse, or the escalator, is 5 metres. In this house, let's use the rule to find the sloped length of this roof. That's C in the rule. Here, A equals 2 metres and B equals 5 metres. Pythagoras' rule to find the hypotenuse is C squared equals A squared plus B squared. A equals 2 and B equals 5. So A squared equals 2 times 2, B squared equals 5 times 5. Now 2 times 2 is 4, 5 times 5 is 25. To add them, 4 plus 25 is 29. So C squared equals 29. But we want to find the length of C, not C squared, so there's one more step. C is the square root of 29, which is 5.4. The length of the slope of this roof is 5.4 metres long. In this example of a toy crane, we will rearrange Pythagoras' rule to find the length of a small side. We'll call the small side A. In Pythagoras' rule, a squared is added to b squared. So to find a squared, we will do the opposite operation. We subtract b squared from both sides. So a squared equals c squared minus b squared. In this toy crane, c equals 13 and b equals 5. That's 13 times 13 minus 5 times 5, which is 169 minus 25. So, A squared equals 144. And then we square root 144 to find A. The length of the small side of this toy crane is 12 centimetres. Even though Pythagoras' rule only works on right-angle triangles, there are all sorts of right-angle triangles in 2D and 3D shapes. Can you see all the right angle triangles in these shapes? Now, are you ready for some challenges in two dimensions and three dimensions? Here's the first challenge. Let's make a spiral with right angle triangles. In the first triangle, both sides A and B are 1 centimetre long. So, by the magic of technology, that means that the hypotenuse of C is the square root of 2, which is 1.4 centimetres long. In the second triangle, the hypotenuse C is the square root of 3, which is 1.7 centimetres. In the third triangle, the hypotenuse C is the square root of 4, which is 2 centimetres. And this pattern continues to make an amazing spiral. Let's do another challenge. This bolt has the shape of a hexagon. It has 6 sides. Each side is 10 millimetres long. Let's calculate the area of the hexagon. It's made of 6 equilateral triangles like this, or 12 right angle triangles like this. In the right angle triangle, C equals 10 millimetres and B equals 5 millimetres. We use the a squared rule. A squared equals c squared minus b squared. That's 10 squared minus 5 squared. So 100 minus 25 is 75. A is the square root of 75, which is 8.7 millimetres. Now we work out the area of one right-angled triangle. The rule for the area of a triangle is 1/2 multiplied by the base multiplied by the perpendicular height. In this right angle triangle, that's 1/2 times 5 times 8.7. So the area of one right angle triangle is 21.8 square millimetres. There are 12 triangles though. The area of all 12 right angle triangles is 261.6 square millimetres. Now for the third challenge. This square picture frame has a diagonal of 10 centimetres. What is the length of the side of the square? Okay, for this challenge we work in reverse. Notice that the diagonal of 10 centimetres is the hypotenuse, called C. We'll use the C squared rule. C squared equals A squared plus B squared. But the sides A and B are the same in this square, so C squared equals 2 times A squared. Since C is 10, that means that 10 squared equals 2 times A squared. So 100 equals 2 times A squared. Again, working in reverse, if we divide both sides of the equation by 2, then A squared equals 50. The reverse of squaring is to square root. So, A is the square root of 50. So A is 7.1 centimetres. The length of the side of this square is 7.1 centimetres. Okay, our final challenge is to use Pythagoras' rule in three dimensions to find the length of the rail of the roller coaster. In this part of the roller coaster, the vertical height is 4 metres, the horizontal length is 8 metres, and the depth going back is 6 metres. Look closely. There are 2 right-angled triangles in different planes. We'll do two steps to calculate the hypotenuses of these two triangles. First, we find the hypotenuse of the flat blue triangle. A is 8 and B is 6. So using Pythagoras' rule, C is 10 metres long. Last, we find the hypotenuse of the upright orange triangle. Side A is 4 metres. Side B of the second triangle is actually the hypotenuse of the first triangle. It was 10 metres. So using Pythagoras' rule, C equals 10.8 metres. The length of the rail of this part of the roller coaster is 10.8 metres long. Thank you for watching.